Got the new ZVS inductive driver in. More heavy duty. It's instead of just a couple transistors, it's two on each side. Much bigger heat sinks. Running, it stays at about 90 to 100 degrees on each of the heat sinks. Both sides. It's got a coil with probably two or three times the number of turns that the old one had. So over here. These ones are all shot. Dead. Second one dead. This bigger one had more transistors, but these heat sinks are too small. And the single fan really didn't keep it down. These things would still get up to 200 degrees, 250 degrees, at 300 degrees. And it was only using a two or three turn coil, right? And the new ones, much more. So, just flip it on, just run at 12 volts. Got a 35 amp breaker now on it. It runs at about 6 amps, which means the output from the up converter, which is taking 12 to 24, is running at about 3 amps, right? 24 volts, 3 amps, 12 volts, 6 amps. And then the heating of it happens fairly rapidly. So, put this in there and see how long it takes to go red. So let me get a bigger one. This guy at work. Stick this in the middle. See the amp draw comes up, right? It's at 6 amps. We're at about 16 amps, which means 8 amps at 24 volts. This is what's feeding in there, right? SpongeBob time. It's 5 seconds to 10 seconds. So it'll take about a minute for this to go red. And this is based on the just the time it takes to keep the thing up. Measure the temperature soon. This will actually bring it to red hot. It's about 800 degrees. Which ain't too shabby. We're at a minute, right? Just past a minute. Minute five. The amp draw actually goes up a little bit with this guy. It's at 16, now it's at 20. So as it gets hot, it seems to be going up. And it's probably having to do more work to keep it. You can see it's starting to turn orange. It's starting to burn the wood underneath it. Smoke a little. With a bigger metal load, it actually draws a lot more current. If I try and stick the pipe in here, if I try and use this pipe, I can put it in to about halfway down here. Maybe not even quite halfway. Like a third of the way. And if I do that, it'll pop up to about 30 to 40 amps draw. Right? If I put it all the way in, it goes off the end of the chart. And it doesn't trip the breaker, because the breaker, it would have to go over 70 amps here for the breaker to trip there at 35 amps, because it's a 24 volt side. Right, so let's drop that screwdriver up to red hot. And we're at about 2 minutes, 30 seconds right there at the 20 mark. It's almost at 1,000 degrees.
pop it out. Amp draw drops way back off. It's red hot. Trying to generate some sparks off the wood there. That's interesting. Works a lot better. Let me put that back in there and just let it duke itself back up to red hot. But notice that, so it's at the 20 amp mark, right? A little over. 12 volts fed in, 55 amp in breaking. So let's have a look at the transistors of these larger heat sinks. Man, working quite well in that regard. Much better than those other ones. And it's back to red hot for just a few seconds there. I dig it. So now we need to see about the right configuration in place. In terms of how we want to do that thermally. But at least this inductive heater can work and runs, and it's got the two fans on it, which keeps it nice and cool. Keeps the heat off it. Pulling 10 amps, 24 volts is all. That's plenty to be able to use for like a small steam generator. Interesting is it's hard, but it's not hot enough that it bends that screwdriver, so it's a nice hardened screwdriver. Curious, huh? Works pretty well. Now I can get back to trying to actually make the thermal amplifier thing and see how that works. Running is 6 amps, 3 amps, 24 volts. Not bad.